Chosen families, thank you for joining us for Coffee with Chosen. I hope you've been enjoying these little moments that we can bring to you before you start your day, and I hope that they have been of value and of help to you. Today, I want to talk to us about homeschool. I see so many of my friends saying, help, I cannot do this. I was not cut out for this. And there's so many funny memes all over the internet about moms trying to homeschool. So I have a feeling that some of us are a little bit stressed about that. So I wanted to share with you just a few ideas to help make this time a little bit easier. Number one, I want to encourage you to do it your way. Your way is going to look different from your neighbor and from your best friend and from some other moms in your kids' classes. You've got to find your way. There's no right way or wrong way, especially in this time where we're all under a lot of pressure. We need to give ourselves grace and find the way that works for us. Secondly, even though I just said that about finding your way, you need to consider that maybe your way might not be the best match for one of your kids or two of your kids. So be flexible. You may be really highly structured, and that is great and fine, but that might not work for one or two of your kids. So be willing to address it on a child-by-child basis, because we're all different as moms, our kids are all different as students, so we need to be able to adapt for each child. We need to give ourselves time to find our rhythm. We need to plan in lots of breaks. Breaks should include lots of good physical activity, running around outside, playing, just doing whatever you can do to get in some good physical activity. There's like great videos you can find on YouTube for exercise inside if you're stuck inside because of the weather. So make sure you're moving, make sure you're eating, make sure you're having water and hydration. It's really important to keep our kids well hydrated and making sure that they have snacks that are high in protein just to help stabilize blood sugar and help them just to feel more relaxed and calm. We also really need to ease our expectations. And I was thinking this morning, I'm hearing about a lot of cancellation of standardized tests. And I think our government is setting a good example for us to just lower some expectations. In a normal school year, we would have a lot going on, but this is not normal. So we need to be willing to take some things off of our to-do list. We need to be a little more gracious with assignments and things that we're working on with our kids. So just adapt, take some things off the list. Just do what you need to do, because this is a really unique time and we just need to get through it and come out stronger on the other side. And so that is my last point, is to put relationship first. I have had someone tell me before that our kids are going to have many teachers, but they're only going to have one mom. And our kids need that mom right now more than they need a teacher. So we really need to prize and uphold that relationship above all things. So you guys have got this. You can homeschool, I promise, and I'm right in it with you. Good luck, and I'll talk to you guys soon.